Hello folks, welcome to day 206 of the Streamer Day Challenge. Now, this makes a change. I'm not late, but I'm early. Today there are change of plans, as the stream title suggests. I'm going live now, and I'll stay live until about 5:30-ish. And then I will have to head off as a change of plans. Why is it not working? I saw we had this working last time. Well, that button actually did something. Apparently none of these buttons do anything. What the hell? Nope. Try restarting the game. Is there an exit button? The Java update, apparently. And I've been updating and installing Java the last few days. Over at EE, we've got servers. So, been setting up our Minecraft servers and that kind of stuff on new servers, updating stuff as it needed updating. It's been interesting. So, today, we're playing some Star Trek Online, and thought it was rather fitting to mention something I saw. Great. My game just crashed. Well, that's something I just saw, is my game crashing. But, I'm on Facebook, and I saw a post about the new Star Trek that's coming out in January. Now, they have a picture of the new ship, the Discovery, I believe they're calling it. And that's all people saying how bad it looks and that. I couldn't actually see the teaser video thing because I'm in the UK, and apparently the video is not available in the UK, so that's just great. But I could see the slight picture they had of it, and I was looking at it, and I was like, why are they complaining about how this ship looks? It doesn't look that bad from what I can see in this picture. Obviously, I can't see the video, so maybe there's something else about it, but it doesn't look that bad. Well, I was scrolling through some other things on Facebook, and I got a view of the back. What the hell have they done to that ship? All I can say. What the hell have they done that ship? Like, really? What have they done? So, we're going to be continuing the voyages of the USS Ziggy Stardust today with Commander? I'll double check when we load in. David Bowie. We'll be going through a couple of the missions. Probably only have time for one or two, depending how long it takes. Every time I load in, I always have a... This is rather annoying, actually, these Star Trek Online fans. Look at how that's all formatted. That pains me to see.
Obviously, the Davidians have found a way to harness this surge of Trialic energy. The existence of the Davidian portal means they're traveling freely between the station in the present and in the past. Since 23rd century technology can't detect the Davidian phase shift, that time period is rife with potential victims. The only choice now is to stop the incursion at the source. You'll have to take that portal into the past and find out how the Davidians are creating this new surge of Trialic energy. Stop them and find a way back without altering the timeline. Don't worry about temporal investigations. I'll pull a few strings. They'll never know you were gone. Best to keep your team small, just in case.
Yes, I'm sure they'll never know we were gone as part of the temporal agents. Thing I've not looked at for quite a while is these skills. I hate working with these skills. I never know what to actually do. Yeah, I'm Commander 21, so we should probably try and get down to some of this Commander stuff. What's this? Increased turn rate. I wouldn't mind that. Improved targeting. That would be quite nice. Advanced targeting. Let's get us down into the commander thing so we can actually take a look. Hull plating. This reduces damage taken. Okay. Increase the rate at which your hull is passively repaired. Shield regeneration, shield hardness. Weapon amplification for now. And shield hardness. Okay, let's take a look at the ground. Hit performance. No, that's alright. Okay, we'll do that. These have their skills as well, don't they? But I don't actually know. Training specialization. I need to be higher to do that. I can promote them. Okay, that's actually something I have to. Oh. Move house. Hang on, what? I don't fucking understand any of that. It used to be easy. At least with sliders and shit. Right, what have you got here? You've got those weapons. Pretty good. There we go. Right. Oh, there's something under my mouse, which was really pissing me off. Anyone got shit armor? You've got. Come on. You got that. I'm gonna discard. I can't be able to actually sell them. There we go. Decent stuff there. Alright, we should be good for an actual mission. Everything old is new. Alright, so we need to go to Drazana maintenance levels. Okay then. Let's head on down to the Drazana maintenance levels. Well, we've got to get to the station first, but yeah. Oh, just a quick note. We are what? 10 minutes in and I've not mentioned it yet. If you're watching this on YouTube and the quality is horrendous, I apologise. The file size for a 2-hour stream yesterday was almost 8 gig. And I guess I could put it into Premiere and try and get it smaller. But what I'm doing is I've lowered the bitrate for the recording. So streams will notice, auto-navigate, stream will notice no difference in quality because I have two different encoders running. I have one that will sort out stream, one that does the my local recordings is what I put up on YouTube, and what I wanted to do is try and have those 1080p, because I can't get 1080 with streaming, because I can't. CPU and that can't handle that. But I wonder if the NVENC would work for that. Be a test, that could be a test. See how low we can get the bitrate and still get 1080p quality. We'll have a look. But yeah. For now it's 864p streams, 1080p for the videos for YouTube. But because I've lowered the quality, if it looks like shit, I do apologise. I can't see what that's doing right now until the end of the stream. Hey, get out of my fucking way.
Welcome to
Yep. Just let me dock, mate. 160 days now, as we're on day 206. It's gone extremely quick. And, oh, wrong way. Over here, apparently. And I'm, for the most part, really enjoying it. There are days when I don't want to stream. A probably modulated energy discharge should allow us to use the portal. Okay, let's do that then. What I do want to check before we go in is, am I looking for everything old as new? Anything on here? Yeah. Okay. Do I need to shoot this thing? Okay, that's what I needed to do. We're still injured on the station, sir, just in the past. We need to be very careful here, Captain. If we damage the station or injure anyone, we could damage the timeline irrevocably. Even if Drake doesn't care about the Temporal Prime Directive, we should. We're still Starfleet officers, after all. Set weapons to heavy stun. We're still in the computer core, Captain. Strange, I wonder why there's nobody here. From what I remember about this time period, there should be someone here. Okay, yeah. At least we're wearing the right uniforms. Okay, and this is the timeline we came from originally. I investigate Temple Probe. So that is somewhere then. We'll check this area for it first. Check up here. Stuff. Park. That wasn't what I wanted to do. Here, the station is on medical alert. Non-essential personnel are confined to quarters and the computer core is locked down. Bullshit, that lockdown works both ways. No one can get in, but we can't get out. Luckily for us, we can't get out either. Luckily for us, these old systems had some well-documented problems. It shouldn't be too difficult to override the controls. The old geotronic computers have a memory fault that makes them susceptible to overloads. An overload could cause it to lose processes, like the one locking the door to the cuticle. Okay. Okay. Right, what have we got to do here? Overflow memory bank 1. Apparently we've done that. Flowing 2 and 3. That is probably the one that's up here, right? That is one. Cool. It is. Not fall down this little gap, wherever that is. Already fallen down there once. What's this? Field integrity console. Switch banks. Memory bank in banks 1 and 3. Okay, memory bank 1. Now doing good, but we need to overload it. But we've got banks 2 and 3 overflowing, sorry. Okay, let's take a look. Need to probably enable something. Bank switch, bank. I did it, the door should open now. Hey, what are you doing here? Just normal stuff. What are you doing down here? This station is on medical alert. Nobody's supposed to be in the computer core area above me. Hey, is that a weapon? Don't try anything, or I'll have to stun you. The lift shouldn't even have let you come down to this level. How did you get here? I'm the reporter from the future. I was stuck on the lift when the station went to alert. This is where it let me out. You should have used the intercom to call for assistance. It's not safe to move about the station during a medical alert. Right, I should get back up to the main station area. Follow me, I'm going to call security for an escort. I guess you're right. Look, just go up to the maintenance lift and get to the emergency medical center as soon as possible. Get checked out. There's a doctor up there who will set up a triage center for the affected patients. Thanks. Transducer relay, what the f- transducer. Now I'm reading a patrol team ahead. Since the station is on medical alert, they're probably following a standard patrol pattern. We might be able to sneak past them or even lock them in one of the side rooms. Well, one of our team members is in there, but hey, they knew the plan. Hey, activate the stealth module. Get out quickly. You're not part of my team, are you? Come on. Okay. I don't need anything. Chip. That's that locked. Right, let's go. Where's my team? Come on. I'll just stand there then. Wait, what if the temporal probe's in there? Bloody is as well. Don't want anyone coming in on us. They're able to unlock it though, surely us locking them in there ain't gonna really do much if they can just unlock it from inside. You know. Oh bloody hell, right. Dance, Shank, Flame. Do we have Dance, Shank, or Flame anywhere? Vulcan, right? Dance, Shank, or Flame. Flame. Travel, many bank. Travel, bank. We could have bank. Bank. Pin wide when. This probe is collecting medical data. Looks like the Narkul are interested in the effects of Dvidian neural draining on humanoid psychology. If they can acquire enough data, they might be able to duplicate the ability and weaponize it. Just make sure that doesn't happen. Collect the data and erase the files. Okay, we need to find a Planck regulator. What the fuck is a Planck regulator? Oh, you all just stood outside, okay. Thanks for the help in there. What's to that weapon? More triadic waves. Okay. Oh hey, you shouldn't be here. You should get up to the quarantine area. Actually, I need to use that console. I'm really busy with this diagnostic, sorry. You really should go up to the quarantine area, excuse me. I want you working on. I just run level 3 diagnostic on the subsystem computers on the station are state of the art. They can simulate an entire copy of this station and display every piece of it as a wireframe model. Perhaps you could show me? I'm really busy with this diagnostic, sorry, excuse me. Okay. Okay. So you knock someone out. Warning, improper access may cause injury, okay, and or death. Right. For hardware access, disable all power taps before servicing. Discharge static electricity before contact with leads. Unlock safety cage prior to access. Unclamp data lead to replace regulator. Okay. Disconnect power. Discharge static. Unlock safety cage. Remove the computer monitor. Take the Planck regulator. Planck regulator. Okay, we got it then. Oh, that's just some gas on the floor. Just keep going this way. That leading me to this. I imagine. Or there's probably some way to go here, isn't there? Yeah. We'll check this area first. We'll probably find McCoy somewhere. I feel like we need to get this floor. Bloody colour. The maintenance lift. Ah! Nothing loaded in. This isn't the power distribution level, sir. Security's overridden the turbo lift. They must have detected our arrival. Station security will probably be here any minute now. If we're going to get out of this without a fight, we'd better look for alternatives quickly. We'd like to find a console that we can use to override the turbo lifts so that we can keep going. Override the turbo lifts. Use this. A group of Starfleet officers head, sir. If we're cautious, we won't be able to avoid them while they aren't looking. Use the command keys near your bridge officer portraits to direct their movement. Set them to passive mode if you don't want them to attack. Hey, we've been here. Let's go. So, we should be able to find an induction coil on this level as part of the power systems. Then we simply need to rig the subspace inducer to the sensor array and we can pinpoint the Davidians. Let's just leave them alone. You there, don't just stand there, come over here and give me a hand. People are dropping like flies on this station, all I can do to keep up. What's going on? Some kind of illness is affecting the people on this station, blue flashes and ghost stories. There has to be reason for it. You just stop it. People are dying here. What do you mean to do? As far as I can tell, all these people reported seeing those strange blue flashes of light. Now they're all dying. They're worse than dead. Their brains are gone. Whatever this disease is, it's suppressing brain activity at an alarming rate. It's almost as if the energy between the neurons were being removed. Yeah, okay. Reinforcing a drain shield generator. She told me to grab something and I don't know what it was. Find and help McCoy pioneer. Take readings. Drained lieutenant. Oops. Not what I wanted. Don't want my gun out either. Where's the lieutenant? Give the lieutenant. Potassium levels elevated, neurons limited. Yeah. Yeah, that means, but yep. Cool. Take readings from, I'm guessing, this person over here. Ready to try some neurosurgery? Okay. Calibrate cortical stimulator. The voltage for the resting potential. That. The voltage for that. That. Let's try it. Didn't work. We need to try different settings. Okay. Normal human neural resting potential is minus 70. Okay, normal human neural activity is plus 30. Neural charge at rest, possibly charged to sodium ions exterior. Sodium exterior, potassium interior. 70, 30. I've forgotten what I actually need now. Please work, please work. Inhale. Action potential. Neuron open sodium gate. Sodium transitions to interior. Neural charge switches from minus 70 to plus 30. I think I'm getting this bit. Minus 70 plus 30. out that one. I think it's this potassium and sodium stuff I need to sort out. He doesn't have a doctor. Finding city calls the CA so it will reset the brain back to normal, hopefully with a little push. And did I do that one? I can't remember. Hey, I think that worked. It worked. We need to get this to the station commander. Come on. Go. Yank it out of here. Borrow and let's report. That's literally what we're doing. Okay. Save through here. Is this where the phone is at? No. Okay, so the emitter has adjusted the active sensors for the station. What do you make of these readings? Oh, fuck. Imaging shows that the station is becoming suffused with trialic radiation. The radiation is coming from Griffin's comet. The comet itself is emitting mass amounts of trialic energy. The Davidians must have realized this natural source of energy. Natural source of the energy. And they're using it as an easy way to shift into sync with us. It's like riding behind the wake of a ship in the water. But that's not all they're doing, sir. They're harnessing the trialic energy and infusing it with the chronoton particles. With that, they could have enough energy to move the entire station out of phase. Maybe... what? Maybe even the entire sector. We have to stop them. Yeah, we probably do have to. The comet is the key, sir, but we can't do anything about the comet without a ship, and I don't think a 23rd century vessel is going to be able to do the job. I'm sure the Ziggy Stardust 8 could. With this information, it's clear that we have to find some way to destroy Driftman's comet, sir. We can use one of the auxiliary reactors in sync with the subspace emitter that we've hooked up to the station in order to make a temporary portal that will take us back to our time. Once we make it back, we'll have to report in and find a way to bring a ship back with us to destroy the comet. Harmonize an auxiliary reactor to generate a temporal portal. Temporal portal. Okay. Redirect reactor to trialic, whatever. Ah! Not what I wanted. So I thought it was dead. Ah, let go of me. Oh, fuck. I just realized what's going on here. Oh shit, didn't read it. Fuck, well, it's gone now. Why are these guys not actually attacking anything? If an enemy of the crew, if it's an ally of the crew, will assist. I don't think running at it and doing that is going to do much. But hey, I'm just a tactical officer. Bolster that weapon as we walk in here. Something else you need. Actually, I have a friend who took a little too much triolic radiation and could use some pyrenoline. A friend, eh? With all the radiation flares that the station's experiencing, we're probably going to be a little short on pyrenoline ourselves. I could maybe spare a hypo, but if your friend is getting radiation, he or she's on the station already. I'll need a double dose to chelate out a significant amount of triolic radiation. You should never lie to your doctor or your bartender. That much radiation would mean you've experienced something close to the epicenter. Like fooling around with the trialic waves. You don't need green blood and pointy ears to know that that is a bad idea. When the people on the station really needed it, you came through. I appreciate that, and I think I can spare a few doses. Just don't let the station's captain hear about it. Aren't they still, like, right next to you? Look, I'm not sure who you are or where you came from. I'm not one to look a gift horse in the mouth. I'm just an old country doctor, but I know better than to ask too many questions about a little unexpected help. You probably shouldn't loiter around here too much longer, or people will start to ask questions. I'm going to put these cortical stimulators to good use. And thanks, you've saved a lot of lives today. Let's go home. New 23rd century visitor, I'm guessing. If we're actually going back, I'm going to be really annoyed. Oh, come on. Hang on, if we just started again. What? What the fuck? My other temporal probe's right here. Well, okay. What the fuck's going on, though? Why am I back here? So the unknown values. Okay. That should have been easy to work out. Go back, please. Set it to 1 because I don't know what the fuck it is. I can't remember what the fucking number was to start with. Right, we're at 12. Okay. Right, for fuck's sake. 9. Of course, there's an enemy operative this time. Multiple of them by the looks of it. Oh no, this is one guy. A little bit pissed off that I have to do this again. I don't know what the fuck happened. I clicked continue and it started it again. That's why we're up here. We're going for that fucking console, weren't we? There was a console here last time, wasn't there? Or am I mad? No, the console's over there. It's on the side. That's really annoying to do the entire thing, to then have to do it again. What the fuck is going on? Why is this not? Alright. Okay. Go down. Not sure. Need to switch something to bank one. I can't remember where I did that. Get your head out the fucking thing. Rather pissed off. Also, there's like a million enemies apparently walking above us. Not being friendly this time. If someone wants to shoot us, we'll fucking shoot them. Stand there as though nothing's happened. Yeah. Hey, I was just gonna lock you in there and be nice, but now you die. Miss my medical officer who would heal me every so often. Is a useless door, right? Okay. Did the whole fucking thing again. Tank regulator. What's the bit? I completely forget how to do the next bit that involves the cortical stimulators and shit. Let's lift, okay. Fuck, piss them off. Four? Guess that wasn't a hypo. I'm on team. Nice, nice, nice. Fuck, they just stand there. They really need to fix that. And they need to fix the bug where your game just suddenly decides you gotta do the whole fucking thing again. Sure, we can get one somewhere around here. Boy, where the fuck are you? Stop moving. Just to stop moving. Yeah. Minus 70, plus 30, this one here. Oh, look, I'm a genius. Like I've been through this situation before. Yeah, come on, let's go. Going through here, aren't we? Yeah. Hello. Let's borrow this out of here. Whatever that is, I'm sure it'll just keep working. And they'll never notice. My door just casually opens. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ooh. Mm. All interesting shit that I've seen before because the game's making me do it again. Take them. Taking out that portal. Wait, let's do it. I don't think you need to activate yourself, module. Yeah. Home. Hope it actually works this time. Hey, it actually did.
So Driffin's comet is the source of the triolic radiation. That explains a lot. However, we cannot simply destroy it in our time. The Davidians have the means to go back to the 23rd century and harness its energy there. However, that will be their only other chance. Before that, there's no Drozana station, so there's no place that will be close enough to the comet's trajectory to be of use to them. The only logical solution is to alter the past. Destroy the comet there, and save the Federation. As it happens, I have access to a way to transport your ship back to the 23rd century. It's risky, but I think the odds are in your favor. And if they aren't, there's always time for another try. I'll make the arrangements. Stay in touch. Drake out.
Cool.
Until congratulations. Next time.
Nice. Bring up to my ship before we take the next one. That was annoying. Do it again. Alright, we should have time for one more. Okay, there's no voice acting for this one. We're determined that the Davidians are using the triolic energy of Driffin's Comet to ease their entry into our phase variance. That's long. That is the cause of all the incidents in the neutral zone. But it's worse than that. It's possible that given the amount of triolic and temporal energy in that comet, that the Davidians will be able to destabilize the aerospace surrounding the comet enough they will pull it and everything into their own phase variance. In essence, they're trying to steal an entire sector. The resulting effects to the surrounding space would make the destruction of Romulus look like the popping of a party favor. Okay. The only thing we can do to stop it is destroy the comet before the Davidians can use it. It's not enough to do it in the present, because the Davidians would still have access in the 23rd century when the comet moves past Drozana Station. We have to destroy it there. You'll need your ship this time, so you can't use the Davidian portal on the station. I can help you get to the past, but you'll need to follow my instructions precisely. Yeah, sure.
Until next time.
Passed out. Go to Beppy 113. No, I'm not going to do that. Oh, I press B for a map. Go to sector space. I actually thought we were in sector space. We'll turn off again. At some point, I may actually get a warp core that can go faster than 6.6. Would be quite nice. Information is simply redacted. Oh yeah. You should feel privileged, Bowie. Very few people ever get to see this system. The organization has gone to a lot of trouble to keep it off the navigational charts. This start is ideal for what Starship pilots call a slingshot. Section 31 uses it from time to time to deal with problems that take a more creative approach to solve. Your best chance of getting back to the point in time where you need to be is to use the star's gravity to accelerate your ship to such a high speed that you'll be able to access the time continuum. I've taken the liberty of having the light speed breakaway calculations added to your ship's database. You'll need to hit a series of points as you move around the star. After you make your approach, you should see a navigational beacon. Aim for it, and you'll have the correct trajectory for the slingshot. It's a tricky maneuver, Barry. If you don't hit each point in the correct order and time, it won't work. I hope your helm officer is up to the task. One more thing before you start. I also added a holo emitter to your vessel. You will appear to be a Klingon D7 with the appropriate access codes for the time period, but still have access to all the 25th century firepower you'll need to deal with the comet. Don't alter the timeline any more than you have to. Destroy the comet and stop the Davidians. But other than that, try to stay out of trouble. I'd wish you luck, but I have a feeling you wouldn't think I was being sincere. We're ready to engage the holo emitter and start our run around the star on your command. Let's go. I guess. Well, this is fast. I don't think I quite hit the correct trajectory for that, but there we go. Captain, based on the decay of elements in the system, we have arrived approximately 150 years in the past, somewhere around Earth year 2265. Incoming hail, it's from a Constitution-class starship identifying itself as the USS Reuben James, putting it on screen now.
Attention, unidentified ship. I am Commodore Jacob Ross, in command of the USS Reuben James. We have been searching for a Klingon vessel reported to have attacked a colony in the Gliese system. You fit the description of the ship we are looking for. Unless you can prove you are not, we will take immediate action.
Commodore Ross, why do you look like you have a modern bridge behind you? Captain Reuben James has closed the channel. They're not responding to hails. And weapons are charging. We cannot seriously damage Commodore Ross's ship without risking damage to the timeline. But we must defend ourselves and complete our mission. Recommend we fight to disable. Let's go.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Full spread, torpedoes. Fire when ready. Bloody hell, that's a lot of... Beam to the station. Love to. Can I get the option?
Any ships in range, please. We need help. I don't know what these things are, but they're all over the station. They're killing people. Please, you have to help us.
Captain, the comet approaching the station. Trilic energy is making it easier for the Davidians to manifest. The people on the station don't have any way to fight them. We'll have to help, or they all die. Take us to the station. Yep, multiple life signs. Oh look, there's the probe. That's easy. At least we don't have to look for this one. Okay. Right. First digit will be 4. Well, there's a 4 in it somewhere, apparently. 2nd is the 4. First digit is a 5. Okay, there is a 4 and a 5, but they're in the wrong place. 2nd is the 5. 3rd is the 4. Okay. Could it be? That's also a 5. First digit is a 2. Probes collecting shock wave energy data from the comet, perhaps the Narkul are trying to figure out where they can find natural sources of trial energy, which they can then use to engage massive time displacement fields. We'll create a massive time disruption, shut that thing down. And we'll take the items. Nice. Oh, thank you for waiting. Through that guy's phase of fire. I have considerably more health than I would like. Hey, where you going? I really bloody see him. Pretty sure someone just shot him down. Any others? Oh, okay. Oh, I'll be right here then. Check my officers and see if any of them have the ability to heal someone. That'd be great right now. Oh. There's a lot of them in here. Ah, let go of me. There's one more somewhere. Where's that? We've been through here. No, apparently not. Ow. Come on, team. Come help me.
But a few hits with a phaser should take care of that. Get my people out of there!
Okay. Let's go. What door? I should probably try and take out the portals first. I probably shouldn't have attacked him straight away. Sake. I don't want to hit him, I wanted to hit the portal. Oh, seven not responding, okay. Wait. Okay then. Which is great. Do I have to start again? Again? No, I don't want to. Well, maybe I was actually hitting the portal and not him. You guys take out him, I'll try and take out the portals. But one of you come and rescue me, and I'll continue trying to take out the portals. Let's get rid of these portals. Give them to me, Rob. Let's get rid of the portals. Right. Get rid of this bastard.
Spike in triolic energy, and I was working to adjust the station's shields to compensate. I went to fetch a hyperspatter, and I was attacked. If you help me, I can finish my repairs before the Trialic energy reaches lethal levels.
Different.
By the way, you can call me Scotty.
You've met me before. I was Lieutenant Bowie back then in command of the Ziggy Stardust that got destroyed. Remember? No? Only a few days ago. We're in the 21st century now. I'm here for a few days of shore leave. That didn't go so well, did it?
The Trialic energy is increasing. We'll be cooked like a haggis if we don't do something about it.
Okay.
There is a wee store on this station. The lass who runs it, Cassidy, said they might be getting a supply of the new quantum flux regulators. The Mark II versions. If we had one of those regulators, I could modify the flux coordinating sensors and use them to modulate the shields protecting the station. That would buy us some time. Go find Cassidy. She'll know where they are.
Oh, right. Is she the one we have to make that fucking tonic for? It is going to be her, isn't it? It is. Take.
What were those things? They were floating, and then one looked at me, and I feel so weak. And then it lifted me up, and it was horrible. Are you looking for something from the store? A quantum what? I'm sorry. I'm just too scared right now to think about selling anything. I'm closing down until I get my wits about me. Maybe it would be best if I packed up and went back to Sherman's planet.
I did.
I don't know. Maybe a nerve tonic would soothe me. Can you get one for me?
Cool. Right. Hey, bartender.
What can I get you?
A nerve tonic.
A nerve tonic? Almost every culture in the galaxy has nerve tonics. Most worlds have multiple variations, and everyone thinks that the one their grandmother made is better than all the rest. Look, I tend bar at a commerce station in the middle of one of this quadrant's busiest trade routes. It's my job to be able to make anything you want, but you gotta be specific. I could make you 14,647 different nerve tonics, 18,397 if you're Bolian. So, what kind do you want? Tell you what, one of the waitresses should be able to help you narrow down what kind of nerve tonic would be best. Talk to one of them, and then come back. I'm sure we can make exactly what you need.
Okay. One of the waitresses.
Who do you think you are? First the lights go all strange, then these weird creatures show up, and worst of all, you're here picking fights with my best customers. Look
Am
at
I?
Dear, brave, handsome Captain McQueen here. He could have been killed. You should be ashamed of yourself.
About the
nerve
tonics.
Tonics. How can I think about nerve tonics when my sweet Captain McQueen is injured? Well, if you want to know about any sort of exotic beverage, go ask that drunken Scotsman. Lieutenant Commander Scott. He knows more about alcohol than anyone I've ever met. While you do that, I'm going to make my sweet prince all better.
Can we just start trying to experiment here?
What can I get you? A nerve?
If you do all that.
Tell you what.
Where do we leave Commander Scott? That seems like the wrong place. Anyone know where I came from earlier? I've forgotten. Oh, found it.
Did you get the quantum flux regulator?
No, but you know anything about nerve tonics?
You don't look like you need one of those.
No.
These wee beasties are troublesome, but they're not as bad as a ship full of angry Romulans. Now, I've been known to enjoy an occasional nip of Scotch whiskey. That's the only nerve tonic you'll ever need. Why do you need to know about them?
Looking for a nerve tonic for Cassidy.
Oh, for Cassidy. Now that makes sense. She's a bonny lass, that Cassidy, and more than willing to spend a little time with a right Starfleet officer, if you know what I mean. But she hasn't got the stomach for fighting. Is she all right? I hate for anything to happen to her.
She's shaken up, but she'll be fine.
Glad to hear it. Sounds like she needs something to take a wee bit of the edge off. And that happens to be one of my specialties, along with transwarp transporter technology and warp field mechanics. Cassidy's been meeting me every evening in the bar for a spot of cheer, but I've never seen her order a nerve tonic. Perhaps if I told you what she likes, you'll be able to figure out the right mix. The bartender will help you.
Okay.
I'll see Cassidy drink. Order these drinks.
Bavarian brandy, blood wine, Venetian mead. Look, okay. I don't want to know about them, I just want to be able to try and order something from the bartender. I'm sure we can figure it out.
What can I get you?
I need a drink.
More details before I can make a drink for you. If you need help, what kind of flavor profile are you looking for?
Sweet.
How strong do you want this drink to be?
A little pick-me-up.
How would you like this drink to be served?
In a stemmed glass.
And last, but certainly not least, what kind of garnish would you like?
A drop
this
of honey.
This should be all the info I need. I'll put...
Thank you. Right. Let's see if this is...
Do you have a drink for me?
Yeah, try this.
I love warm drinks. They're so relaxing.
Glad you found the temperature pleasant.
Ugh, this tastes terrible.
Okay, let me find you something else more suited to your tastes.
What can I get? I'll need some more deep. What kind
hot.
Of flavor profile are you looking for?
Sour.
How strong do you want this drink to be?
It'll pick
How
me up.
Would you like this drink to be?
In a stemmed glass. Drop of honey. Thank you. Pick up glass. I need to remember a drop of honey was part of it. Yeah, try this.
I love warm drinks.
Good.
There's a lovely sour note to this drink. I feel so refreshed.
Good. I'm glad. I thought this would be right for you.
There's just enough oomph to this drink to make it really stick with you. I like that.
Look like you could use a little pick-me-up.
I love the style of this glass. It accentuates the flavor of the ingredients.
Settings are important. The right glass makes the right drink even better.
Honey! Oh, that bit of sweetness is just perfect. It adds the most delightful note to each sip.
I'm glad even the last drop of this drink is making you happy.
Ah, that is marvelous. I'm feeling much better now, thank you. What tool was it you needed? A quantum flux regulator Mark II? I have one of those right here. Please take it as a thank you.
Thank you. Okay. I came in from over here, right? Oh, great. The lights have switched again, Scotty.
The right tool for the right job.
Okay, well, I didn't realize you were going to say more. Captain, the station is safe for now, but we still need to deal with the comet in orbit. The Davidians are able to harness its energy, then they will... If the Davidians are able to harness its energy, then they'll be able to pull most of this sector into their phase variants. Past, present. It will all be disrupted. Take us back to the ship. This is close as the comet stretch. You will take it to Drizana Station, Captain. We need to destroy the comet while we still have time. So a group of Klingon vessels have entered the system. The lead ship is hailing us, sir, putting it on screen now.
Ah, a ship from the House of Duras! I am Captain Bavot, son of Warot, and leader of my house. My brother died due to Duras' treachery. I will avenge his death with the destruction of 100 Duras ships. Prepare to die!
Oh, fucking hate Bavert. Captain, we can't afford to change the course of events any more than have been altered already. And we know that Captain Bavert survives this day. We'll need to attempt to disable his forces. He'll be calling for reinforcements. We need to destroy the comet and return to our time before we're overwhelmed. That buzzing is really annoying. Scan the tachyon particles. Oh, crap. Oh. Well. Full spread. What's this do? Emergency power to weapons as well. Why not? Torpedoes full spread. Fire when ready. Oh, or don't. We're good. Heading for the comet. Don't alter the timeline. I don't want to scan that. I would like to destroy the comet. I guess full spread of torpedoes will do for this big ass comet. Slow us down. Fire up with them. Heal torpedoes, fire that at it. I'm sure that'll do something to it. Spread fire when ready. Emergency power to weapons. Enough of these guys. Fire the bloody weapons. Trying to restore our shields here. Full spread torpedoes. Nice. Oh. Hey, your torpedoes. Emergency power to weapons. Oh, we don't need them, okay. Take out the shards. Take hours to take out the shards, apparently. Oh, comet fragment. Just give it everything. There we go. Love how that torpedo did fuck all. We can throw all power to weapons here. Would it be better? Get a bit of that. That's not doing anything. Emergency power 2 weapons. Nice. Oh, there's still a shard up there. Climb to the shard. Oh, there's bloody D7 battle cruisers in here again. Full spread, give him everything. What was that one I just activated anyway? Far on my mark. Shit. Oh, we got that guy, okay. So I was busy reading that, we took him down. Nice. Can we get the shard now? Shard down. Last fragment to get. Kelvin Timeline Constitution Tier 6. I really want that. Fire everything. Nice. Knight of the Comet complete. Let's return back to our timeline thing, please. I did it, Captain. The only comet debris is too small to be a threat. Now we just need to find a way to... One moment, sir. I'm detecting a temporal anomaly. It's forming inside the Ziggy Stardust B.
If you are receiving this message, then you and your crew have completed your mission. Driffin's comet is destroyed, and the Davidians are no longer a threat to the Federation. You've done well.
Thank you.
And to prove that I'm not the immoral monster that some make me out to be, I'm going to help you. When you last docked at Deep Space K7, I had some modifications made to your vessel.
Really?
One of those is the addition of a Borg temporal node salvaged from a cube in the Batron cluster. It's set to return you to our time. Congratulations on a job well done. Drake out.
Thanks. Can we have used that to get here? When it will be green and that instead of the blue. Oh no, it'll be blue. Okay. Thought it'd be that greeny colour that all tech has, but apparently not. Let's report to our neutral zone contact.
Excellent work. I knew I could count on you. The disappearance of Driffin's comet in the 23rd century will be a scientific curiosity. I have taken steps to suppress information that might reveal our involvement, and I trust that you and your crew will refrain from telling stories about what happened here. After all, we're getting along so well. One thing I hope you'll take away from all this is that any opinion you may have of the immorality of so-called rogue elements like Section 31 is a bit naive. Mm-hmm. Contrary to popular opinion among some Starfleet officers, we do not spend our days plotting evil and committing random acts of villainy like characters in a bad Hollow novel. We protect the Federation from threats. Thanks to you, the Davidians are no longer on that list. If you think about it, everything we do is to preserve the freedoms you so enjoy. You should be grateful. Drake out.
Yes. Grateful, I'm sure. We'll have that as a reward.
Until congratulations, Commander.
Thank you. Acquired new mission duty officers. Where's that at? Sure we can fit that in.
Starfleet Medical has analyzed the reports of...
Go away. Oh, it's right there. Yay. Okay. Well, I shall end here. Apologies for ending early today. I love how that deactivates swinging game. Yeah. At least I didn't start late. I started early today. The reason for that is due to leave of absences and that Ursulite, the event that would normally happen today won't be happening, so I could start earlier. But also there's been a change of plans IRL, so yeah, I needed to be finished for around about now, so that ended quite well. I wanted to finish about 5:30, but 15 minutes earlier should be good. Won't have time for another mission, so we'll end now. I will be back tomorrow, usual time of Monday tomorrow, so it'll be 8 p.m. tomorrow. So next stream Monday at 8 p.m. EST, and that'd be day 207. Of the streamer day challenge. We'll be playing something. I don't know. Maybe a bit more STO for a couple of hours. Maybe some Minecraft, that kind of stuff. We will figure it out tomorrow, I'm sure. So yeah, massive thank you to those who joined me today. If you are new to the channel or haven't done so already, don't forget to follow the channel, follow Twitter, subscribe to YouTube, all that fun stuff. Links are below the channel. As I said, I'll be back tomorrow at 8 p.m. BST for a usual stream. Do hope to see you tomorrow. Oh yeah, you can, if you wish to do so, also subscribe to the channel over on GameWiz, gamewiz.com/count603 if you wish to do so. But yeah, I'll be back tomorrow at 8 p.m. BST. I do hope to see you tomorrow. See ya. Sneak a leg in the night, not tell anybody. Start the car, take a ride out of this city. But you couldn't stay. You didn't want to get away and live a life like a king and drive away with me. Could've gave it everything, could've lived royally. And we could rise.
Just an old t-shirt. Take back all your shiny things if you can't see me right.